the realm of aggression. Back every single one of those, like, Mutual of Omaha specials, at the end there would always be the deep voice saying, and we are the only species that kills, and that turns out to be wrong. Lots of other species kill. They kill members of their own species. They kill them in anger. They kill them in cold blood premeditation. They kill them strategically in ways that would make Machiavelli proud. They do it to each other's infants. They do it competitively, advantageously. We're not the only species that kills. Just to give one example of this, this was a male who had joined one of my troops of baboons a few weeks earlier, and the only way to describe this guy is he had horrible political skills. And he was hassling all sorts of high-ranking guys he should not have been messing with, and one morning, this is what was left of him. And in the 30 years I've studied male baboons, the leading cause of death among male baboons are male baboons. We're not the only species that kills. In addition, we're not the only species that kills in an organized manner. This is what's called a border patrol, a group of chimps in a group that have gotten together and they are patrolling the edge of their territory, and if they encounter a male from another group, they will attack and kill him. And as documented by Goodall in at least one circumstance, things like this, a group organized enough to do this systematically and kill all the members of a neighboring troop. So we're not just the only one that kills, not the only one who kills in an organized way, but this is some proto-version of genocide. We're not the only ones who do this either. So what about us, then, and our aggression? And what you see is some of the time we can just cudgel somebody over the head like any good old primate, but some of the time we are doing stuff that's unrecognizable. We could do nothing more physically challenging in our aggression than pulling a trigger or dropping a bomb from 30,000 feet or looking the other way. We can be passive aggressive. We could damn with faint praise. We can do all sorts of subtle things. Let me give you an extraordinary example of a way in which humans can damage each other for which the world is never seen the likes of before. Every day outside of Las Vegas, there are people who get up in the morning and they are rushing off to work and their spouse reminds them to pick up the dry cleaning on the way home and they say goodbye to their kids and they rush out and they get caught in traffic and they're all anxious they're going to be late at work and they luck out and get a good parking spot and get to work and sit down in a flight simulator, and what they spend the day doing is operating a drone bomber in Iraq that drops bombs and kills people. This is at Nellis Air Force Base. People sitting there spending their work days operating drone bombers on the other side of the world. And at the end of the day, having finished your day doing that, you get up and rush off because you want to be there on time for your daughter's ballet performance and you hug her afterward and you can't believe it's possible to love someone that much. And the next day you sit in this dark room and kill people on the other side of the planet. And there's nothing out there in the animal world that has a precedent for that. And not surprisingly, apparently the rate of psychiatric problems among people who spend their days doing this is also unprecedented. So in some ways, there is no precedent for that realm of us.